88-year-old Mzee Samuel Baker Kasigwa of Chisalizi Village, Dujanga sub-county in Masindi District, is an ex-international who played for Uganda national football team from 1956 to 1966. Kasigwa represented Uganda in a friendly match where Uganda beat England by 2-0 in 1956. He remembers this day like it was yesterday as the barefooted Ugandan players smashed the whites.
So they take us to the England team where they were training. England team, we beat them 2-1. Remember that when we came back, we find because there was a newspaper of the evening, they said, they wrote in the paper saying, England, shame, the England team. How can the Uganda team, barefooted team, beat the England team, national team?
Football then was less commercial, which saw the former right forward winger Mzee Kasigwa retire with almost nothing after playing football for a decade. At 88 years, he has now been grappling with high blood pressure before he suffered a stroke to make his condition worse.
I've been fall sick, but I don't know where the disease came from. So now I'm very weak. I have pressure. I have a headache and a dizzy, stroke, so I'm not all right. My head is not so that. May I am weak and I am tired.
Kasigwa, who is under care of his sons, is calling upon Good Samaritans to remember his contribution to the beautiful game of the football and bail him out with medical assistance. He is also seeking shelter.
I want to have a good house, be sure, dear, because I'm very weak. I want to have a car so that my boy could drive and take him where he want to go. I am where I fist. I grow in something of that nature to keep my life happy.
The ex-international, who is the only one surviving on the 1956 national team, is concerned that many programs which have been undertaken by the Federation of Uganda Football Association, FUFA, towards improving welfare of former national team players are only targeting the recent retirees, and those who have promised him support have not fulfilled their pledges.
There is a group, I don't know where FUFA or where comes from, they were given some prizes. Maybe it was fulfilled that question of yours.
Did you get?
I did not get because I was in the system of 60s. I retired playing football in 1956, so I did not get that. These people selected of people, I think, of Museveni's regime.
Edward Katushabe, a son to Mzee Kasigwa, says they have been overwhelmed by the medical bills because they have to pay a personal doctor to administer treatment from his son's home in the city suburbs of Bina. They now pray for any volunteer who can donate a wheelchair and treatment.
Supposed to take drugs for 2 weeks, which are costing around between 250 in 2 weeks. And after the 2 weeks, you have to go to get more drugs. So in a month, we are spending, which is not less than 600,000. And the other challenge is carrying him. We cannot move. You have to carry him.
Even at 88, Mzee Kasigwa's voice is still strong enough to praise God through worship songs. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.